Given the events of the past 24 hours in federal parliament, there is a common view that politics in this country has rarely stooped so low. It's little wonder the voters Natasha Exelby spoke with today are perplexed. And
I hope following my scenes in parliament had many politicians overwhelmed, but the people they serve couldn't be more underwhelmed.
Parliament has done itself no favours in this whole effort, and quite frankly, I'm very distressed at what's happened to us.
Today we sought the opinion of voters in the three key players' seats. On Sydney's Northern Beaches, aka Tony territory, Slipper's resignation is excellent news.
That was really the only way out.
Sure, the Liberal Party has been gunning for Peter Slipper for quite some time now, but it's worth noting the Liberal Party also endorsed him as an MP for almost 30 years, and he was also a close colleague of Tony Abbott. Some would even call them friends. In fact, the opposition leader even attended his wedding. But these are all irrelevant details in Liberal Party heartland like this.
Well, I think Mr. Abbott is doing a great job and he deserves a good vote in the next elections.
There's no sympathy for Mr. Slipper in his own seat.
They should have fired him for those comments, and he should have left with his head really bowed down low and slithered away like the snake slithery snake he is. He's a slime.
And despite Julia Gillard's gutsy 15-minute attack on Abbott that's been acclaimed around the world, the PM is struggling for support in her own neighbourhood.
I don't know which way to go these days, because no one seems to support the people anymore.
I think the whole parliament itself is an absolute disgrace.
So no matter who wins the next election, it seems voters think they'll lose either way. Natasha Exelby, 10 News.